All right, guys. Just wanted to give you guys an update. There was a lot of people interested in how well this performed, and I had taken out to the range twice just to kind of double check everything, and found it to be just an awesome red dot. The windage and elevation adjustments were easy to make. They were responsive, and couldn't ask for anything more. Now, there was some questions about the durability of this red dot compared to the T1, and I don't think that's a very fair comparison. Although it does look like the T1, and it performs fairly well, as much as you can ask for a red dot. It's not going to be a T1. And I don't think the durability is going to be the same as the T1, but for a range gun or something that you want to plink with, this is absolutely fine. Again, there was a sort of a tint looking through this compared to the aim point. It's like a bluish green tint to it, and it's not as clear as the T1. But as far as a red dot, getting it on paper, getting on target, making adjustments was absolutely perfect with this. Also, the brightness settings, there were plenty brightness settings where we were shooting in bright daylight and it had no problems at all. And I think I had it up to 5 or 6 and had no problem seeing the red dot. At times, if you were to turn it up to 7 or 8, it would actually be too bright. And that was in Florida sun, so the magnif or the brightness settings are no problems. As far as the quick detach mount, it is a quick detach mount. I was completely wrong on my first video about this. I just actually had the lever on backwards, and Marshall had made a comment on my first video saying, telling me that, hey, you have the lever on backwards, first of all, and it takes very, very minor adjustments to get it, where it needs to be. But I've taken this on and off, and surprisingly, it repeats zero. So, if any of you guys have any doubts about it, I wouldn't worry about it at all. This is a great red dot for the price, and I'm probably going to buy another one just because they're so affordable. And if you do bang it up, if it does break, you're not losing quite a bit of money. So that's a quick update. And if you guys are wondering what it's on, I'll go ahead and take the camera off the tripod and I'll show you what it's on. It's a brand new gun for me. So I'll go ahead and show you that. All right, so I'm sure most of you guys know just by looking at the ejection port what kind of gun it is. And I have this Primary Arms Micro Red Dot, and it's sitting on a SIG 556. This is the 556 Classic. It comes with your standard forearm there instead of the Picatinny rail. Really nice rifle to shoot. Recoil feels a lot different than any AR I've shot. Again, it does operate more of like an AK-47 than an AR, but this one comes with the folding stock. Of course, with any folding stock, you're going to get a little bit of play or a little bit of wobble, but that's expected. This one has very minimal wobble to it. And trigger there, straight design trigger, really no bow to it. Trigger to me feels a little bit spongy, but that's just my opinion on it. This rifle actually bought from a guy and he never fired it. It's a brand new rifle and got it for about half the price of MSRP. Still had the blue tag, blue sticker around the grip, and there was something from SIG, like tape that was around the ejection port or something. So it was practically a brand new rifle. Really nice rifle, slightly on the heavy side, but I like the rear sights there. Your barrel type sights, you make your adjustments by turning the barrel here. It's good for 300 yards, I guess. Yeah. Easy to adjust. Really nice shooting rifle. Again, it's the trigger is something I have to get used to. It's not your basic two-stage trigger. Let me see if this is. Yeah. But that's what it's on. So tell me what you guys think. If you guys want me to do a more detailed video on this rifle, I can do that.